And this is why Makis gave the talk to Aliki, and Aliki, we are keen to hear what he would have to say.
Okay. So I am going to try and share Evdokimos' views regarding patients' perspectives for an ideal user-friendly eye environment and e-health in Greek reality today. Evdokimos is a member of the board of the Hellenic Group of Patients with Chronic Lymphocytic Leukemia. He was diagnosed 6 years ago when he was 41 years old. At the time of diagnosis, he didn't have any presenting symptoms, so it was an accidental finding at a routine blood test. So Evdokimos told us that when he was diagnosed, he was quite happy with the information that he received from his treating physician, information regarding the disease and the different treatment options. However, he wanted to do a little research by himself. And for that reason, of course, he chose the web. What he wanted to do, he wanted to become more familiar with terms such as lymphocytes, monocytes, and all those terms that we physicians use very often without realizing that, in fact, it is medical terminology and not everyone is very familiar with it. So what he found out when he tried searching the web is that there is a lot of information, but there is a lot of unstructured information of questionable validity. So instead of getting answer, he got more questions. What he described to us is that it was a real surprise for him to realize that in Greece, in an era where nowadays we can do a lot of things through applications in our mobiles, through iPads or laptops, through eye technology, like go virtual tours or even book theater tickets from all that, health literacy is not so advanced. So a little back research for what he saw is that there are not so many web pages, at least translated in Greek, where he could find the information he was looking for. And he came to the conclusion that this may be due to the lack of bodies and patient organizations who were actually going to claim for their worries. So at that point, a little description about the Hellenic Group of Patients with Chronic Lymphocytic Leukemia. It's a new patient organization. It was established a year ago. Up to today, it has 70 registered members, and of course, new members are already registering. This patient group was established so as to actually claim the needs that patients have, and we described also earlier. So the goals from this group of patients is to provide assistance, support, and to try and solve problems faced by CLL patients. Also to create a website so as to inform and educate not only the patient but also the public about hematological diseases and therapies, all the new treatments and rehabilitation. Also in the context of education, to organize seminars, conferences, lectures, and any other activity that actually promotes research and progress in medical care. Also to create valid information with regards to the rights of hematological patients. And this can only be done with cooperation with the Greek state and also European agencies, but also with other patients' associations and organizations. Goals also are to promote the welfare of CLL patients and also to promote research into the knowledge and treatment of hematological diseases, but also in the context of peer support to organize social events so they can meet, the patients can meet with each other more easily and outside the disease, sorry. Currently, The Hellenic group of patients with chronic lymphocytic leukemia is organizing a series of seminars on CLL in close collaboration with other physicians. And they are in the process of organizing a peer-to-peer support network for newly diagnosed patients. So in other words, when a patient is just diagnosed, he can refer to the CLL patient organization and they can show him the way, they can help him, they can guide him through his disease journey. And of course, they are already online and they are raising awareness about the group's existence, and this is the website of the organization and also the website based on their Facebook. So here they try and show also what are the group's goals, what they are currently trying to organize, but also they are going to host all the relevant information regarding the disease. So what is the current situation in Greece? Background research, as Evdokimos described to us, showed that today there are no or there are only a few valid Greek websites containing understandable information for both patients and family, and I think that the key word here is the term understandable. So once again, it becomes very clear that patients need to have a sort of interpretation of the medical terminology. They need to have clear meanings in what they're receiving as information. And of course, once again, they stress that there is no website providing information on patients' rights and how to claim them. So what is the patient's view of an ideal user-friendly environment today? In other words, which are the tools to help them understand their disease, the available treatments and the therapeutic methods, and what are the needs that CLL patients have in everyday life? First of all, it's the need of the accredited website in containing information in a comprehensible format. And here I think we can compare with what has already been presented today. So we can see that patients actually need and they want an application and they want tools for recording their data. They want to have their data on their own hands so they can see, they can have their own follow-up, and then if they wish to, they can share it with their physicians. They need where to find who lists, so whatever happens to them, they would know who to contact, and they need answers to their questions about the illness and available treatments as well as side effects. They want to become close and to get in contact with other patients, and this can be done on online chat forums. They want to hear about other patient stories, even through patient interviews, but they also want to listen to more physicians informing and consulting patients and relatives about their disease. And of course, they want information in multiple formats, a sort of electronic library with information about their disease. And what Evdokimos wanted to highlight is that what's important is to have valid and comprehensible information about CLL, and that goes for other diseases too. Okay.